please.
So not personal.
Bonnie, your name for the audience.
Yeah, Bonnie Laufer.
Oh, I had a nightmare that said, last night I had a nightmare that someone thought I was 40. I've never had a nightmare like that before, but oh my god, I must be subconsciously starting to worry. So I said, oh, you're 40, aren't you? 40?
It's horrible.
Are
you crazy? God, you look 20.
Thank you. Oh my god, that's another age anxiety dream in my life.
Look, I've been having Hugh Jackman dreams for the last 2 weeks.
Yes, well, that happens to the best of us.
Yes, I know. I'll tell you. Anyway, oh, what a great role this must. I mean, it must have been just fantastic being able to play such a tough as nails woman.
It was great, and what I liked about her is that she remains completely feminine and female as well. I wasn't interested in making her this sort of robot, sort of guy type thing. You know, she's got kind of mood swings and gets tearful, and you know, has that whole sort of feminine energy, which I thought was really cool.
Yeah, a real woman who kicks butt.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, like the best of us.
Exactly. Yeah. Now, I mean, I want to know where on earth you learned to be such a great stunt woman.
I have no idea. I mean, I went and saw the movie for the first time a couple of nights ago with my brother, who's one of my four brothers, and every single time I turned my back, he went, "That's not you. That's a stunt girl. That's not you." Because I literally was the least athletic person in the world growing up. I had no interest in sports. So I just went, "No, that's me." He can't even believe it when I'm running, you know, let alone doing anything else. So it's quite funny.
I mean, you obviously, when you did Underworld, you did a lot of that too.
And
so
that was really where I learned it. I mean, I had such a great stunt team on there. And then we spent 3 months, you know, over and over training like crazy. So it was really down to them that I was able to do this movie at all.
What on earth was it like getting up on those wires and flying and then landing on Hugh Jackman?
He was a little worried, I think, because I was supposed to really land kind of, you know, one knee either side of his face. I did kind of go, oh, am I really doing that? Is it going to come out okay? And he, I think, tried it with the stunt girl and then thought, oh, now the actress is going to come in and just pulverize me. But we work really well together. We, you know, just physically we work well together. And also, you know, it's impossible not to get along with you. So we had a really good time.
Yeah,
and I didn't squash him.
Yeah, well, and good thing you didn't. Yes, because, you know, that wouldn't work on Broadway.
Lynched.
Yeah, wouldn't work on Broadway. What was it about Hugh that ultimately really just impressed you about him?
Well, he comes with this tagline that he's the nicest man in Hollywood. And so we all made it our mission to uncover what the dirty secret was, because you assume that there must be one. So we would sort of jump into his trailer when he wasn't expecting us and, you know, try and catch him. And he was always, apart from, you know, occasionally practicing tap dancing for his play, he never was up to anything. He's just the nicest man in the world.
Are you a monster movie fan? Have you ever been into that?
Not at all, no. I mean, I was a very oversensitive child. I was sort of led out of Greystoke sobbing, so I didn't really make it past apes. So not really. I mean, I was attracted to the character of this, but I think it's really fun. There's something really exciting about the whole gothic thing.
Yeah. I mean, at this point in your career, you've done such great stuff, and I was wondering if there's anybody that you really aspire to work with.
To work with. I always used to say Scorsese, and then I got to work with him last year, so I was so pleased about that. And actually, there are a lot of actresses. I think there's some fantastic actresses around, and usually as the woman, you're kind of one of the only women. So I think, you know, I think Angelina Jolie is a fabulous actress. I think Kate Winslet's a fabulous actress. It's so unusual to get two young actresses together. That's what I'd really like to try there.
Yeah, I would have to find. That would be fantastic. Yeah. I have to ask you, speaking of Scorsese, I saw the pictures of you as Ava Gardner in the Vanity Fair shoot, and oh my god, I mean, how daunting was it to play somebody
terrible.
Like
that? Terrible. I mean, it's bad enough when it just says, oh, you know, a very attractive woman comes in the room and you know, having a PMS day or something, and you think everyone's going to just go, can you leave? It's much worse when it's Ava Gardner, and, you know, not only is she this fabulously beautiful woman, but the kind of charisma and immense love that people have for her, you just hope you can a tiny bit do that justice.
I can't wait for that movie. Underworld 2, what's the deal?
Well, they're definitely rumbling about it. You know, there's scripts going on and stuff. I don't think there's a definite date to start, but it definitely looks like it's probably going to happen.
We need you to stop doing, you know, take a break from the stunt stuff and do some more romantic stuff, I think.
Ava Gardner. I'm doing a film next with Billy Bob Thornton, which is more of a sort of psychological thriller.
Good, and then go back to the stunts. You need a break on your body.
I do, you know. I have a child. I have to look after myself.
Exactly. You did a fantastic job in this.
Thank you.
I can't wait to take my kids.
Oh, thank you so much.
Nice.